Mobile's brought the web billions of new users and has introduced a lot of new possibilities for web developers to take advantage of, such as direct touch and manipulation, high-density displays, and new hardware capabilities such as geolocation. I'm Paul Kinlan, and we're going to look at some of the trends that we've noticed at Google and tell you where there's a great opportunity for you if you get the fundamentals right. The Google PageSpeed team had a great question. For a mobile page, does poor usability diminish the benefits of a fast page load? Now on the web, if the average page load time is about 7 seconds, and we at Google recommend that you should aim to load your page in less than 2 seconds, but even if you do achieve those goals and the user has to spend an additional 5 seconds pinching and panning and zooming just to find the content that they're interested in, then the site really isn't fast at all. We looked across the top 1,000 sites and sampled over 1 million URLs at random to determine how well the web works on mobile, and we found some very interesting results. We found that a high number of sites had content that forced the user to pan, pinch, and zoom around a screen just to be able to get access to the site. And from a recent ad study, we know that users hate having to do this. We found that over 32% of the top 1,000 sites had text that was too small for users to read comfortably. And this got even worse for the long tail of the web. Now, imagine you're on your mobile and you're viewing a page that's not mobile friendly, but has been designed to use a 12-point font. Because of the scaling that the browser introduces, it actually reads like a 4-point font, and this is just not great for users. A large number of sites also block the ability for users to scale their screen. In a test that I ran, 15% of sites that had a viewport also blocked zooming. This is bad for users who require enhanced accessibility and are frequently being blocked from being able to view a page comfortably. Not only were displays suboptimal, interactions were hard for users too. Over 60% of the top 1 million sites had issues with interaction, where elements such as links and buttons were too close to each other for the user to accurately click on and complete their intended action. I've dropped this in because it's a pet peeve of mine. I hate typing on my mobile device, yet many sites still have really long forms that don't autocomplete or help me enter text. Why? And a recent study by the ads team showed that users hate having to fill in forms too. People still use Flash and other embeds. These tools just do not work on the mobile web, so why are we still using them? For someone like me who believes in the ubiquity of the web, it's clear that it's not easily accessible everywhere. As depressing as these stats are, there is hope. It presents a massive opportunity for you and your business to get ahead of the competition and delight your users. The Google PageSpeed Insights team built a tool to help you identify issues with the performance of your page load and address these problems with actionable guidance. We've extended this tool to now include detection of common user experience issues. But how do you avoid these mistakes in the first place to build a great experience for your users? I'm going to talk about 7 simple steps to get you started building great mobile web experiences. Now, this sounds silly, but you need to understand that you must go mobile. If you're not thinking about it already, your users will want it and your competition are probably already building it. Now, there's actually a lot of things that you need to do to go fully mobile, but these next set of tips will help you avoid the common pitfalls of mobile web development. The most important and critical thing that you can do is to always use a mobile viewport meta tag and always size it to the device width and set the initial scale to 1. This viewport will work really well across all devices. Users hate panning. Always ensure that the content fits on the viewport width and does not force the user to scroll. For example, developers often don't scale their images correctly or size tables to fit on mobile, forcing the user to pan left or right. Never ever disable zoom. Even though your users hate being forced to zoom, there is very little reason to lock this experience, even if you're building apps. And by making sure that your users can zoom in, they will thank you for it. So simply use the default viewport meta tag we presented earlier, and you're good to go. When it comes to reading text on the screen, the Apple iOS team said it best. Above all, text must be legible. If users can't read the words in your app, it doesn't matter how beautiful your typography is. And the same applies for the web, so we recommend that you use at least a 16-point font, sensible line spacing, and a good contrast in your text. Limit the use of web fonts to just the headings so that the body copy is immediately visible to the user. Web fonts are loaded from the remote server, and the text is blocked from rendering until it's been fully downloaded. So remember, the most important thing in your site is your content. Make it easy for people to interact with your page. Increase the minimum touch size to 48 pixels and add padding of at least 7 millimeters to areas of your site that will accept user input, especially if there are other touchable areas nearby. This will help users and browsers understand where the clicks happened and complete the action for the user. make it simple for people to enter data into a form. Guide users through the data that they need to enter on your form by giving them a hint with a placeholder. For example, if you're entering a telephone number, have a sample telephone number in line in the form element. Add labels to tell the user the type of data and also drastically increase the touch target size for the form fields. For example, use the label to tell the user if it's a home telephone number or a work telephone number that you're expecting in the form. Make sure you use semantic input types, such as telephone, number, and date, to give the user the appropriate keyboard to make their lives so much easier. Browsers and mobile phones have great tools to make it easy to enter data, such as a phone dial pad, or even a quick hint with the at sign on the form when you're expecting that data. The browser understands a huge amount of information about you, so let the browser help your users by enabling autocomplete. Tell the browser if you're expecting a street address, a credit card number, an email address, or even a person's name, and it will automatically fill out the form. PageSpeed helps with most of these issues, so use it at every single stage of your project so you can catch problems before they occur. For example, you can use the API to check your site on every single deploy or build, and it's as simple as issuing a curl command to the API with your site address. If you follow these simple tips and use our Web Fundamentals Guide with PageSpeed Insights, you'll be off to a great start. Thank you for watching. I'm Paul Kinlan. Now go out and build some great sites that work on all devices.